basically we covered, up to now we have covered three topics. Name is digital trees and clustering. So today we are cover the next one, association theory. Kind of a common data mining algorithm, we'll discuss that. So we have been following this table for a while now. So the association rules falls only with the association category or the task of data mining. If you can remember, we divided all the data mining algorithms into five tasks. So association covers and the associate. So we'll discuss what that is. There is something I found when I'm looking for this, looking for content on this. So just to, by just looking at this, you know what this each algorithm does. Right? So I thought of including that one as well. So what decision tree is, what clustering is, what time series is all about. So in one picture, you can get the idea about what all the algorithm does. Right, so let's go to the topic. Now, this one, if you read any data mining book, guaranteed this story is there. I don't know how many of you have heard this story about the deer and Nappy case. I think all of you have heard this story, right? Yes? Yes or no? Okay, just tell you what the story is. Supermarket chain in US, they have found out every Friday men who are buying beer, along with the beer, they tend to buy nappies as well. Now don't ask me why. It's something that they found out using that evidence. Some are saying this is a mythical story. In some books it's just a story. Because there is no research paper as such. So, but basically what this idea is, associate my idea is, if you buy something, you tend to buy some other thing as well. I think that picture might be, if you are buying something from Amazon, if you buy something, just after you buying that, you will get this kind of a list of items customer bought along with the item that you have already bought. Now, so what's the importance of that? Obvious importance is, yes, they will gain revenue. They will gain revenue by selling more items. That's the obvious thing. But on the other hand, there are other things as well. Now, if you look at the Amazon example, now, if I buy something, so I can simply select the next item from the available list rather than going, searching and selecting this item again and again. So by doing that, what the Amazon doing is, of course they are making customer happy, number one. Number two, most important thing is, they make the stay in their browser or stay there in their shop much lesser. Now by doing that, they make sure they can support more customers. Now when it comes to this this case, the supermarket case, what they said was they moved the beer racks closer to nappy racks. But by doing this, what they have done, whenever you buy the nappy, and you can easily buy the beer or other way around. Right? Now actually this happened to me once in Sri Lankan the supermarket. It was some other story. It was other way around. I wanted to buy a toothbrush along with a toothpaste. Now, I bought the toothbrush in the first floor and I had to get the brushes, get the toothpaste, I had to buy in the second floor. Right? So, when I asked from manager, he said, nice story. They have done it purposefully. Why? In Sri Lankan context, what we used to do? You bought the brush from the first floor, and on your way, when you see some item, you tend to buy more. Right? So that's a cultural difference. So you see, whatever, you don't need a data mining algorithm to realize that you need toothbrush and toothpaste together, right? So that's obvious thing. But in this case, it's not obvious. When you buy beer and nappy, it's not obvious. So, I mean, if you look at this supermarket chain, Amma thing in Walmart, huge set of items are there, in thousands of items. So it's running a simple query or doing simple analysis might not solve your query. And you can't simply find, okay, running a single query, you can't say, okay, if you buy this item, you need, people might buy this item as well. Or sometimes there can be, so we always talk about two items. There can be multiple items, more than two as well. So because of that, you need special algorithms to get this data. So that is where the association theory comes in. So I have a small explanation about what the association rule is. Association rule learning is a popular, and as I said, well, research method discovering inverse relation between variables of large databases. Now, mostly we talk about the items selling together, or that's why we call this algorithm as market basket analysis or shopping basket analysis. But the cases are not only the shopping basket analysis. Now, I have read some research papers. When it comes to some sports, right? Some sports in some teams, some players tend to play well when some other players in the team, or other way around. If he's not there, some players tend to play well. If I can remember correct, some basketball team, they have done this kind of analysis, and they have selected the well-suited players for the different teams. Right? So those stories are there. So your association theory is not relevant, though we call it as market basket analysis. It is not relevant to this the shopping the cases as well. It can go, basically, if you want to relate something, who are the people going together well, something like that, you can use this association rule. So basically, I have written about the when it was found. So Rakesh Agrawal is the one who introduced this association rule for discovering the relatives between production large-scale transaction data. So when you say association rule, inside that there are a lot of algorithms. So we are not here to discuss about all the algorithms available. But there are a lot of algorithms, and there are some fine-tuning of the existing algorithm as well. So it's some mathematics involved here. I just copied from the Wikipedia. I don't want to go into details again. So there are ways of calculating some parameters are needed. You can say, okay, when someone buys this item, item X with item Y, so what is the probability? Like there are some parameters of the data set. We are discussing that part. So normally, we association rule, we often written as when people buy, normally in mathematics, this says x implies y, but forget about the mathematics part. So normally, what we are saying is, if person buys x, what is the chance of buying y? That's what in association rule, or in association algorithm, that's what we, the meaning of the x implies y. Yeah, meaning that whenever x appears, y also tend to appear. That's the rule. So again, I don't want to go into details of this. Only thing I want to tell you is there are two parameters in the algorithm. So support and confidence. So what support in the sense? How many? Now let's say, okay, let's take the beer and nappy case again. Let's say X is beer, Y is nappy. How many items out of the entire transaction, let's say 1,000 transactions, how many transactions have beer? Did I say X for beer, right? Yeah, so beer, how many transactions have beer items? So basically, you divide the entire transaction, let's say 1,000, and number of transactions you have beer. So that's what you call support text. So in this case, nappy and beer together, how many items do you have? Nappy and beer together, how many transactions here, nappy and beer together, divided by total number of transactions will give you the support value for those two items. Number two, confidence. Some are saying importance as well. Basically, you divide support XY based on the value you got from there, and only the number of items where the beer is. You divide the number of item, the number of transaction you have both items, and divided by the number of transactions you have only beer, or number of number of transactions you have beyond in the transaction. So basically you take those parameters. Again, it's not a nothing to remember, I just because we are using these parameters in the coming demo, that's why I thought of including them. So those two parameters are important when it comes to analyzing your the data mining set, because otherwise there can be some items. For example, let's take the beer and nappy example. You might not see beer items much, so then your research, the sending them together is not much value. It doesn't have much value. So likewise, you need those parameters to define how much valuable your output is, how much valuable your finding is. Right, so these are the two parameters we'll be using. Right, so I'll. So I'll explain the we have done the initial part before I said, but again since there are a few new people, I'll explain them again. So what you have to do is you have to create a new project. Analysis service project. Okay, so I have a data set. So I'm using the sample data set. So if you want to do any exercises, you can download this sample dataset called AdventureWorks DW 2014, and I'll be using these two views. So basically, one view is this view gives you the orders. Like, so we have the order number and the customer, region, and income group. Basically, you won't be using for these three columns. We'll be using the order number. So basically, order number is unique here. If you look at the other view, for each order, what are the items sold? Right. So if you look at these two orders, it has three items. Right? For this order, SO613133 order, they have sold three items. So in this case, cycling capital, sports 100, and load something are selling to this. So if you look at this transaction, SO613135, there are five items are sold. Likewise, for each order or each transaction, there are multiple items. So our task is to find out what are the items selling to get. Right. So. So let me create a data source. So my data source will be the AdventureWorks database. So I'll create a new one. So my database is the AdventureWorks DW 2014. Is done. So let me provide my Windows authentication name. That is done. Now I need to, now this points me to the database. Now I need to select out the those two views. So if you can remember last time, we simply has to select the one view. Most of the time we selected the target mail, but this time we have selected two views. One has the order list of orders, and the other one has the for each order what are the items sold. Now, and then we have to relate these two views. If you are using tables, created proper foreign key in the column, you don't have to do this manually. If not, we have to do this manually. You have to drag and drop and create a link like this. If you are using a If your variables and your foreign keys are created accordingly, this will be automatically checked. Since these are views and there are no foreign keys, you can't create the foreign keys between views, you have to create this manually, right? So basically you are done with your desktop, then creating a binding structure. So again, not a big deal. So same thing what we did last time. Only thing is, so last time we selected other data mining algorithm. So this time we have to select association rules. Microsoft association rules. Right. So again, subtle change to the last time. So here, last time we had only one table. So that was the case table. So here what happens, this is the case table and this is nested table. Nested table means in under that table there are multiple items. So if you can remember, we have the list of orders. So this one is just multiple for each order, what are the items there. So this will be the case table or main table, and the nested table will be the line items. Okay, so here order number will be the key. And what we are going to, our input and the prediction will be the model. So other thing you don't need. So only you need, what you need is the order number so that it relate goes to tables. And what we are going to predict is the model of the item. So yeah, this one I explained last time as well. I'll just run through. So when you have a data mining model. But normally what we do is we build the model and test with some data to see whether your model is correct. So normally in data mining, default rule is 70-30 rule. That is, there are different rules. Microsoft, what they do is 70-30 rule. That is, you use 70% of data to build the model, and balance 30 to verify the model. Normally you don't use same data set to verify the model where you use the to build the model. So, I mean, it's no point, right? So you 70% of random data will be used to build the model, and 30% will be used to verify the model. So there are lift charts and to verify whether your model is correct, which I'm not going to do here. So here I'll go with the 70-30 rule. And yeah, Microsoft has another thing also. You can set the number of cases. Like you can say, okay, select 1,000 cases to get the model as well, so we won't be using that one. We simply use the default one. So you have to process the model. Right, so important thing is not this, I'll show you the item sets. So if you look at this diagram, this will say now people tend to buy high pressure pack, tend to buy water bottle. Other way around, if you click this color differently as well, people tend to buy rod bottle cage, tend to buy water bottle. And people tend to buy mountain bottle cage, tend to buy water bottle. And so you can see that there are four different colors as well. So if you look at, there is one, okay, this one. Now, so this is, now if you look at all the other, people tend to buy this, tend to buy this. So both way is not working, but this case, both way is correct. People tend to buy touring tire tube, tend to buy touring tire, so, and people tend to buy touring tire, tend to buy this. So basically, in this, that case, there is no predominant item. Both items are mostly going to be. So there is another one more. Likewise, you can find out what are the items selling together. If you look at this item set, here if there are things that you can do, you can say, okay, minimum support. Okay, I can say, okay, minimum item set greater than 0, I can say, okay, greater than 2. So, set this, so then it will display only the items. Now, if you look at 0, even one item will be shown, which is no point. So, but here what we can do is, the two items selling together can be this way. Likewise, you can tweak your existing the parameters and get it accordingly. Now, maximum support is 9 means at least you should have this item, these two items should be in 9 transactions. That's what we are saying here. So if you want, okay, no, I need more than that, you can change the parameters and get the data accordingly, depending on your data set. So you have these rules as well, where you can again get the data set accordingly. Now, another one thing I want to show you, there is a tool called Add-in to Excel. Though it's Add-in to Excel, it's again uses the SQL Server Analysis service, where you can do the same thing. Like, so there, so this is the data set again, sample data set. So if you install this add-in called DM add-in sample data, the new ribbon will be added to the, normally you will see only this ribbon to your table tools, this analysis ribbon will be added to your Excel. Now, there's a very important thing in this Excel sheet, Excel add-in, so let me go through the shopping basket analysis. So here you have to select the transaction ID and let me check for that. There's an optional thing. I'll show you what that is. So now you don't have to go into that Excel or other analysis service and go to various steps. Here it will simply shows you in the Excel itself what are the items selling close together. So this is saying these two items. Mountain amount. There are 438 number of sales. And important thing is, this will tells you the amount of them. Now that's what the importance for a business person. Doesn't matter how many number that you are selling. What matters is how many revenue I am gaining for this by selling these two items. So sometimes you can see your selling numbers might be very low. The number of sales might be very low, but you are getting higher revenue. So then you can focus on that stuff rather than focusing on some items which where you get. Now, for example, this one. So these two items, number of sales are 231, but the value you have got is, lesser to the other items. If you look at this one, 81 sales, but the sales amount is higher. Likewise, so it's not only the number of item it matters, also the amount is also matters. So that's what this analysis tool does for you. Also, if you install that tool, adding, you will have a data mining tab as well, or a ribbon as well. Again, you will have the associate rule, and then you can basically do the same thing what you did in the Excel, or rather the analysis service, right? So, but again, the problem is the now Excel, you won't get so Excel you might not be able to load a lot of data, right? Excel you might have some distributed than using SSS, but if you have more records than 20, I mean if you have more records then or more data, obviously you have to go with the analysis service. So also there is a, you can predict as well. Let me try it. Okay, so let me do a small prediction here. I'm not going to. I'll quickly write. What I'm saying is, I need 4 items which are selling. Okay, let's select from water bottle. Basically what I'm saying is, I need 4 items which are selling, people with buying with water bottle. 4 items buying with water bottle. So, right, it gives me these 4 items. Right, so if you want to find out the other mining model we will use, what is selling mostly. But if you want to find out what is the item you want, you want to find out with this item, what are the items you are getting selling mostly, you can do a prediction query as well. So prediction query, again, I won't be going into the large details of prediction query. It has a lot of parameters, so this is a very small query on association theory. Yeah, so again, in the previous mining sessions, that there is a thing called parameters, right? So you can set the parameters. Now you can see the minimum item set size, that is item set, maximum item set count. So how many item set, let's say you have a large item set. So if you didn't specify a number, it will calculate, it will go through all the item sets and get a model. So if you want to set it for a value, let's say 200,000, it will select only 2,000 the items only from the data set. The thing is, otherwise it will go through the entire, if you have a very large data set, it will go through all your data set and try to build the model. If you select some value, it will select those number of items randomly from the existing data set. Second one is maximum item set size. So in a given item set, how many numbers you need to select? How many number of items you need to select? So one transaction, basically what we are saying here is only 3 items we are selecting, not all. I mean, if you look at normal transaction, you might have large number of transactions. So here what we are saying is, select only 3. So likewise, there are other parameters, probability, support, the parameters where you can change, and the depending on your data set, depending on the environment, you can tweak these values and get the correct data set. So, yeah. So these are few references I added. So basically, this is a very not a large topic like the clustering and others. It's a very small algorithm, and it's somewhat this, I mean, out of the existing algorithm, this somewhat famous or somewhat the frequently using algorithm in the industry. Yeah, so that's all about the association algorithm. Any questions? Raise your hands if you know the answer. What are the two important parameters in association algorithm? Data mining task, where the association rule fit in? There are five data mining tasks. I can't tell what are those because it should be much easier. But where this association rule fit in out of those five tasks? Association rule fit into with which task?
Association?
Yeah. Yes, association
any questions?